Did you know that the first major Tesla autopilot software didn't come out till October of 2015? That's over 12 years after Tesla was founded. But despite this, Tesla has basically become synonymous with self-driving software today. Meanwhile, Google started their self-driving car project way back in 2009 with essentially unlimited funding power. And since then, most legacy automakers have also entered the race with their own offerings. Yet they're all ears behind Tesla today. So, how was Tesla, a company that was barely getting by, able to build autopilot so fast? Well, taking a look back at history, Tesla first entered the autopilot scene in September of 2014, when they started including Hardware 1.0 in new Tesla Model X's and S's. Hardware 1.0 was pretty straightforward, relying on just one camera, the front-facing camera. Tesla cars at this point did have a rear backup camera as well, but this wasn't actually utilized by the autopilot system. Hardware 1.0 also boasted 12 sensors, a radar system, and most importantly, a Mobileye IQ3 processor. Mobileye is an Israeli software and hardware manufacturer who has been working on developing full self-driving for decades. In fact, they've been involved in the space since 1999. As a result, getting chips and software assistance from Mobileye was no doubt a massive advantage for Tesla. Mobileye helped Tesla develop their first round of lane assistance software and develop the fundamentals of Tesla Autopilot. Unfortunately though, this partnership didn't last too long, as in July of 2016, Mobileye would announce that they were withdrawing from the partnership. This wasn't because they didn't want to help Tesla or anything like that. Rather, a Tesla would get into a fatal accident in June of 2016, while the owner was using the self-driving software. And even if the crash truly was because of negligence from the driver, Mobileye didn't like the way that Tesla was releasing essentially prototype software to the public, who likely didn't fully understand the risks of using the software. After this, Mobileye would go on to form partnerships with other automakers like BMW, and Mobileye would eventually be bought by Intel. In the meantime, though Tesla lost a critical partner, they had picked up on significant skills while working with Mobileye, and this would allow them to come out with arguably their biggest hardware update in October of 2016, Hardware 2.0. Hardware 2.0 exponentially increased the amount of data that Teslas were collecting on the road. For instance, Hardware 2.0 increased the number of cameras from 1 to 8. Teslas now had 3 front-facing cameras, 2 side-facing cameras, 2 side-rear-facing cameras, and 1 rear-facing camera. This 8-camera system is what Tesla still uses today. In addition to extra cameras and sensors, Tesla would also beef up the computer side quite substantially. But this time, they would have 2 new suppliers, which were Nvidia and Infineon. Each Hardware 2.0 system came with 1 Nvidia Parker system on chip, 1 Nvidia Pascal architecture-based GPU, and 1 Infineon tri-core CPU. As you guys know, Nvidia is the largest and most advanced GPU manufacturer in the world by far. Considering that they have 28 years of experience under their belt, this is not surprising by any means. Recently, AMD has been making significant progress in terms of graphics processing within the gaming industry, but Nvidia is still by far the leader in the commercial space. Similarly, Infineon is a German semiconductor behemoth with again decades of experience. Anyways, Tesla would continue their partnership with these two companies, and together they would soon come out with Autopilot Hardware 2.5 in August of 2017. This was a rather small upgrade. Tesla would upgrade some of their sensor equipment, and they would increase the 2 Nvidia Parker systems on chips from 1. But that was pretty much it. Just a year later, Elon Musk would announce that they were ditching Nvidia-powered AI systems in favor of their own systems. And sure enough, when Hardware 3.0 came out in March of 2019, all of the hardware and software would of course be from Tesla themselves. If you haven't noticed yet, the first monumental advantage Tesla had over the competition was that they were able to secure enormous partners early on. And let's just be clear here, these companies were helping Tesla, not the other way around. Nvidia, for instance, was worth multiples more than Tesla during their partnership. With that being said, I don't want to take away from the outstanding work the Tesla team themselves have done, but it's no question that Tesla full self-driving would be nowhere near where it is today without help from Mobileye, Nvidia, and Infineon. However, just because you get help from the big boys doesn't mean that you'll become a big boy. We all know what happened with GM and Nikola. So let's take a look at how Tesla cleverly built off this jumpstart, starting with data collection. Mobileye didn't like that Tesla was deploying beta software to the public, but this was actually vital for Tesla's success in the autonomous space. Here's the thing, Google and Ford and GM have massive budgets to develop and test self-driving software. Meanwhile, Tesla was struggling to just stay afloat. In fact, in 2018, Tesla almost went bankrupt during the Model 3 production ramp. As a result, there was no way for Tesla to meaningfully compete against the big players using just internal development. Knowing this, Elon cleverly used the cars they sold to their advantage. Now, Tesla wasn't actually selling that many cars in comparison to Toyota or Volkswagen. However, the cars they were selling annually were a lot more than the small fleets that Google and GM were testing on. For instance, as of March 2019, Google's fleet of self-driving cars was just 600 cars. At the same time, Tesla sold double that every single day in 2020. Moreover, not only are Tesla's customers subsidizing the cost of building up a fleet of test vehicles, but they are also subsidizing the cost of research and development by directly paying thousands for beta full self-driving. As Tesla has ramped up production and is continuing to grow production exponentially moving forward, their data collection capability has also grown exponentially. Just take a look at the numbers. As of April 2020, Tesla had a total of 3 billion miles on autopilot. And at that point in time, their data was growing at 186 million miles per month. At that same rate, Tesla would have upwards of 5 billion miles today. Meanwhile, their closest competitor, OpenPilot from Calm AI, has collected just 35 million miles. That means that Tesla is 142 times ahead of their closest competitor in terms of data. I think nothing more has to be said about Tesla's data lead. Moving on, Tesla is also not distracted like legacy automakers. Tesla is a fully electric automaker, and this was a massive disadvantage during the early days, as it made it super difficult for Tesla to get to scale. But today, it's clear that electric cars are the future. We have seen a global movement towards clean energy and electric vehicles. States like California have even passed legislation mandating an eventual transition to electric vehicles. All of that is great, but the biggest catalyst of them all is that Tesla has innovated so much in terms of battery technology that owning an electric car is not only cheaper in terms of maintenance, but it is almost cheaper to actually buy in the first place. When this domino falls, it's basically game over for ICE vehicles, as there is virtually no reason for the average person to buy an ICE vehicle anymore. And the thing is, Tesla is getting really close to tipping over this domino, and legacy automakers know it. As a result, they're currently scrambling to transition to electric vehicles themselves, as they have neglected the trend for years and years. Thus, they aren't really able to fully concentrate on autonomous software development. This makes sense, as it would be stupid to focus on growing revenue through autonomous software sales when your core business is in danger of getting wiped out by a bunch of rookies. Combine this with a plethora of different models, trims, colors, years, and markets, and you'll quickly see why it's so hard for legacy automakers to focus on fully autonomous software. Conversely, Tesla only has a handful of models, and they only update these models every several years. So, Tesla is able to laser focus on just battery and self-driving technology. Even within their self-driving technology, Tesla has kept it extremely simple. They don't use LiDAR, they don't use HD maps, and they don't use mapping cars. All they use are regular old cameras, radars, and sensors. Not only does this make Tesla's self-driving system cheaper to produce, but more importantly, it makes it significantly easier to produce. If Tesla was installing LiDAR on each of their cars, their production capacity wouldn't be nearly 500,000. And I'm sure Tesla's engineers took into account production hits when deciding against LiDAR, which brings me onto the final factor allowing Tesla to build autopilot so fast, which is their team. Tesla has built an image of being the most innovative car company out there. And today, Tesla is the first company that comes to mind when you think of self-driving cars. You definitely don't think of Ford or Toyota or Volkswagen. Considering this, where do you think the best engineers and programmers want to work? Tesla, of course. In fact, in November 2020, Tesla was ranked the number one place engineering students wanted to work. As the article points out, that's a massive advantage. But this interest isn't just limited to engineering students either. The same perception is quite common amongst experienced engineers as well. I mean, it makes perfect sense. Would you rather work for a company that's creating the future or companies that have stagnated for decades? At the end of the day, Tesla was actually a relatively late entrant into the autopilot scene. However, over the years, they have brilliantly leveraged bigger players, the cars they were selling, a lack of focus from competitors, and an ingenious team to bootstrap Tesla full self-driving to where it is today. What do you guys think is the main reason for Tesla's rapid development process? Comment that down below. Also, drop a like if you guys can't wait for level 5 autonomy. And of course, consider joining our Discord community to suggest future video ideas, and consider subscribing to see more questions logically answered. But until then, I'm Hari, and I'll see you guys on the next one.